From the Holy Gospel according to Saint Mark. When Jesus had crossed again in the boat to the other side, a large crowd gathered around him. He stayed close to the sea. One of the synagogue officials, named Jairus, came forward. Seeing him, he fell at his feet and pleaded earnestly with him, saying, "My daughter is at the point of death. Please come lay your hands on her that she may get well and live." He went off with him, and a large crowd followed him and pressed upon him. There was a woman afflicted with hemorrhages for 12 years. She had suffered greatly at the hands of many doctors and had spent all that she had. Yet she was not helped, but only grew worse. She had heard about Jesus and came up behind him in the crowd and touched his cloak. She said, "If I but touch his clothes, I shall be cured." Immediately, her flow of blood dried up. She felt in her body that she was healed of her affliction. Jesus, aware at once that power had gone out from him, turned around in the crowd and asked, "Who has touched my clothes?" But his disciples said to Jesus, "You see how the crowd is pressing upon you, and yet you ask, 'Who touched me?'" And he looked around to see who had done it. The woman, realizing what had happened to her, approached in fear and trembling. She fell down before Jesus and told him the whole truth. Jesus said to her, "Daughter, your faith has saved you. Go in peace and be cured of your affliction." While he was still speaking, people from the synagogue official's house arrived and said, "Your daughter has died. Why trouble the teacher any longer?" Disregarding the message that was reported, Jesus said to the synagogue official, "Do not be afraid. Just have faith." He did not allow anyone to accompany him inside, except Peter, James, and John, the brother of James. When they arrived at the house of the synagogue official, he caught sight of a commotion, people weeping and wailing loudly. So he went in and said to them, "Why this commotion and weeping? The child is not dead, but asleep." And they ridiculed him. Then he put them all out. He took along the child's father and mother, and those who were with him entered the room where the child was. He took the child by the hand and said to her, "Talitha kum," which means, "Little girl, I say to you, arise." The girl, a child of 12, arose immediately and walked around. At that, they were utterly astounded. he gave strict orders that no one should know this, and said that she should be given something to eat. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, Book of Deuteronomy, chapter 30, verse 15, Moses said to the Israelites, "See, I have today set before you life and good, death and evil. If you obey the commandments of God, your Lord, you will live." Again, Book of Jeremiah, chapter 21, verse 8. God said to Jeremiah to tell the people, the Lord said to Jeremiah, "Thus says the Lord, see, I am giving a choice between the way to life and the way to death." So today's readings reveal us three important themes or topics: death, life, and faith. This is something we hear from each reading: life, death, and faith. Yes, dear brothers and sisters, the freedom given to us to choose life or death, good or evil, it is completely given to the Israelites and also to us in our life journey. We all experience often sickness and also experience our beloved people dying. We all experience crisis in our lives. When we are going through this, sometimes we struggle with the faith matters, because sometimes we try to play blame game with God, saying that it is because of God it is happening, or why God did not stop this death, why God did not heal me or heal my family member. Especially when we love our family members, our mother, father, our brother, our sister, our friend, or sometimes wife or husband, well, we all experience. Sometimes the same experience sometimes lead us closer to God. Sometimes the same experience take us away from God. In the times of crisis, times of sickness or death, some people come to God, "God, help me." And the more we approach God and read the scripture and pray, sometimes out of ignorance or because of our limited knowledge about the scripture, people also go away from their faith journey and never return to God. The darkness and also spiritual death enter into their lives, so completely it will become disaster in their lives. So dear brothers and sisters, all the answers the first reading, Book of Wisdom, gives us answers to our faith-based questions or struggling of our life and death. And we heard in the first reading, God did not make death, nor does he rejoice in the destruction of the living. It is very clear. In the Book of Genesis, when God created human being, he wanted us completely to live. So this is the everlasting life. God's plan God's intention, not the death, but life. That is why we heard in first reading, Book of Wisdom, God did not make death, nor does he rejoice in the destruction of the living. And also we heard that God formed man to be imperishable. Imperishable. God did not form a man to be perishable, but imperishable, the image of his own nature, he made him. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Then, how did death enter? And again, by the enemy of devil, the death entered. So that is why, so we all, the people who belongs to that enemy, will become a company with each other. So Bible is so clear, and I read from the Genesis to the last book, Revelation. So we hear about life, we also hear about the death, we also hear about faith. People who has faith understand things better way. Even in our life struggles, we know whom to approach, where to go, how to receive God's blessings, everything possible. But one thing is clear, there are two kinds of death, physical death and spiritual death. Which one is dangerous? It is not the physical death. Spiritual death is the dangerous thing. That is why we are all given a life by our Lord. When Jesus came to give life, through his life, death and resurrection brought us new life. That's why, dear brothers and sisters, through baptism, we become the children of light. We all become children of God. And the life of God, the divine life, enter into our souls, into our hearts. That is a beautiful thing that we experience on this earth. So being a child of God and experiencing the life that God intended, the life for you to live forever. God created us imperishable. So this is fact, the reality, the Bible speaks to us, and he wants us to live forever. The death that we are talking about, physical death and spiritual death, but once we know living in God or living in Jesus Christ will help us to have the life forever. That is why in the Catholic Church, we all celebrate death of the saints. So instead of celebrating the birth of the saints, we always celebrate, because for them, the day ends here, they begin their life in heaven. You know, Jesus on the cross, when the repented thief looked at Jesus, he repented for his sins, and another person blaming, another person, if we are God, so save yourself, save us. And again, the repented thief, looking at Jesus, he truly went through his heart and soul and saw all the things that he did. And finally, looking at the salvation, looking at Jesus, he said, remember me in your kingdom. What Jesus said, today you will be with me in heaven. So that is the welcoming of our Lord. A sinner became saint on the cross and entered into the heaven. So this is what happens through Jesus, through baptism that we receive. We all experience that divine life in our hearts, dear brothers and sisters. That is why today, responsorial psalm, we all responded, I will praise you, O Lord, for you have rescued me. It's not Father Bala rescuing. It's not somebody, your parents, or it's not your husband or your wife or your friends. It is God rescued us. That is why Psalmist says, I'll praise you. I'll praise you. Again, Psalmist says, I like this psalm. Psalm 150, verse 6. Beautiful psalm. All the six verses speak about with the music. Praise God. Thank God. All the things we hear. And again, the last verse, 150 and 6. Let everything that has breath give praise to the Lord. Hallelujah. 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 Let everything that has breath, if we have the breath, give praise to God. And this is something God brought us because death is not death, those who believe in God. And death is a transition, a journey that we enter into heaven. So, dear brothers and sisters, today's gospel reading reveals us the continuation of the last week's gospel. Last week, we heard Jesus calming down the wind and also sea. After that, he came to other side. When Jesus came through the boat, other side, a large crowd gathered there. Why? Because they wanted to see Jesus. People wants to experience healing and wanted to hear from him. A large crowd waiting for him. Waiting for him. There are two things happened in today's gospel reading. Jairus' daughter, that Jairus, synagogue official, approached Jesus and asking for the healing for his daughter. And again, the second one, a woman who suffered hemorrhages for 12 years approached Jesus and asked with a great faith, if at all I touch the garment of Jesus, I may receive the healing. So when you hear about these true incidents, and Saint Mark put them together, and this one, this gospel, so Saint Mark put them, it is look like a sandwich construction. Sandwich construction means we see bread and again something that we want to eat, again bread. We see in today's gospel reading, Jesus, when he came to other side, the large crowd, but the official approached Jesus, and what happened? He fell at his feet and also earnestly pleading Jesus and asking for the healing. So this is something the great a person who is known for the authority and official of the synagogue. So he came to know about Jesus. He knew something about Jesus. Jesus may heal or save his daughter from the death. So that is the great faith he had. That is why this official approached Jesus. And the way he pleaded, my daughter is at the point of death. Please come lay your hands on her that she may get well and live. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. So it didn't come beginning of his daughter's health issue. He came at the point of death. When this official went and asked, Jesus immediately followed him towards his house on the way. And in between what happened, a woman who suffered 12 years of marriage, she touched Jesus' garment. So behind him, she touched. A great faith, if at all I touch, I receive thy healing. And also Bible speaks about, she spent all her money and she suffered a lot. And also what happened? And her sickness so became worse instead of recovering, but became even this woman at the point of death. So there are some common things that we hear from this both the incidents. Number one, the woman and also the girl, their names are not given. Number two, Jairus, the official, and also women in the gospel, they fell at the feet of Jesus Christ. Number three, number 12 mentioned about it, because the woman suffered 12 years, the girl's age 12. And again, we also see, so both the women are called daughter. Daughter, these names are given. But dear brothers and sisters, something we experience here, the faith that father and also the faith this woman had, it's a great faith because, yes, I'm going to Jesus. So as I mentioned at the beginning, same problem, some people come closer to God. Again, same problem, some people go take away from God. But here, these two people approach Jesus because they knew something Jesus could do for their lives. So, dear brothers and sisters, what happened? The woman who touched the garment of Jesus, the power went from him without even Jesus' knowledge. When power went, then Jesus turned and asked, "Who touched me?" Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. There are two touches we also hear. Number one, so human touch. The woman touched the garment of Jesus to receive the healing. Number two, divine touch. Another girl was on the bed, deathbed, and she died. And Jesus touched her hand and also said, "Talitha kumi." So these two touches, one human touch, another one is divine touch. Both are there, but both led to the healing and life. Both led to you, a person, towards the healing and strength and power. So, dear brothers and sisters, when we are reflecting on these two events happen in the life of Jesus, so God wanted to give this healing. And God wanted to give this life. That is what we see, dear brothers and sisters. So once Jesus entered, while people were crying, and also they said that she died. What Jesus said to the Father, "Do not be afraid, just have faith." And Jesus also said to all the people, "This child is not dead, but asleep." Saint Jerome, he commented on this. Both are true. People who said that she died, and Jesus who said she is asleep. Saint Jerome said both are truth, because for the people, for you, she is dead. For God, she is sleeping. So we call cemeteries, the meaning of the cemeteries, a sleeping place. So, dear brothers and sisters, Jesus came to give life. And also the word Jesus used when he touched the little girl, raising, what he said, "Talitha kum." It is an Aramaic word, Jesus also speak this language. And he said, "Little girl, I say to you, arise." Immediately, a little girl received the life, dear brothers and sisters. So in our life, when you go through the struggles and spiritual battles, or in our lives, we go through the things that we don't understand. So Jesus encourages us, as he said to the Father, "Do not be afraid, just have faith." Again, to the woman, Jesus said, "Your faith has saved you." It is not just healing. Saved you means saved your soul, your life, something greater thing than what she is expecting. She is expecting the health, but God is giving her the eternal life. That is why Jesus said, "Your faith has saved you." So our questions today, do I have the faith of this Father? Do I have the faith that saves my soul, my life from the death? And Jesus said, John chapter 10 verse 10, "I have come to give life, life in abundance." Again, John chapter 11 verse 26, Jesus said, "I am the life and the resurrection. Those who believe in me, even they die, they live forever." So having a faith in Jesus, it saves, heals, and strengthens. Today, we offer our lives, dear brothers and sisters. As St. Jerome said, "For you, a child is dead. For God, she is sleeping." So sometimes you may experience dead. But for God, everything is possible. He will bring you light. He will bring you healing. He will strengthen you when you are afflicted. He will give you the courage to face any situation in our life. He also is there with you so that you will make your journey towards heaven. It is possible. Let everybody say, "I will praise you, O Lord, for you have rescued me. I will praise you, O Lord, for you have rescued me." Hallelujah. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.